This is a very interesting article, and I'm gonna link it in the description below. But it says what happened to 10,000 boys kidnapped by Boko Haram. See, the issue here is in 2014, we all heard about the almost 300 girls being taken, but nobody's talking about the 10,000 boys. And during the kidnapping of these girls, almost 1,000 boys were killed during the kidnapping, and the boys were also kidnapped. Now you can read this entire bit here, which is very interesting. But I thought this comment was actually very interesting, so I'm gonna read it out loud. So back in 2014, Boko Haram takes 276 girls from a school, and here in the States, original story talked about the girls being taken, and hashtag being set up, thoughts of US intervention, and the First Lady getting involved. If memory serves, in the same attack, 800 men and boys were killed. And here they were just called people. Not mentioned that they had been singled out because they were not Islamic. And they were all male, or was conveniently left out of the evening news. But a year later, we learn that none of the girls are dead, but all of them have been sold into marriage at roughly $12.50 US per bride. Is that seems to be correct. About a year after that, we learned that the leadership of Boko Haram now sees the value of the girls as a shield and have kept them close to the leadership. The government fears that to try rescue would result in all of the girls being slaughtered. In the meantime, protests happen, trying to push the government of Nigeria to go after the girls. During all of this, not a calls for justice for the 800 slain. Now we know that 1 year before the Chibok girls' abduction, and up to the present, over 10,000 boys have been taken. That's better than 3,300 a year. Nothing said about it. No outcry to bring them back. Not even as much as a hashtag selfie with the president, Obama. Until now, not a peep in the media. All absolute double standard. When the day comes, and it will, that the Nigerian government or even our forces in intervention have to kill these boys who have been pressed into service by the enemy, their blood will be on all of our hands. Their crimes will be on us because we marginalized them, ignored them, and neglected to recognize their humanity. Why? Because they were boys. Really, really good point. And this is really telling because nobody is sharing this about this part of the story. And you know, there were all sorts of campaigns and hashtags to bring the girls back, but nobody gave a damn about the boys. And I want to know where the outrage is for this. Feminists were campaigning for to get the girls back, but when the weight is on the other foot, they don't do the same for the boys. So it's really sad to see, to be honest. Again, I would recommend actually to read the interview and the article itself. As I said, we'll link it in the comments below. And as always, thank you guys for watching, and see you guys next time. Bye.